Hello and welcome to today's tech tip. Today we're going to be talking about how we can report a circle like we have in this opening in the top of this tube. Obviously we can't put a circle measurement through this, and we're going to have some other difficulties because it's also a thin walled material. I believe this is only about 2 millimeters thick. So you can see by the shape of it as I rotate it around, this definitely is not a circle measurement in anybody's definition, except when you look straight down on it, then it is circular. So what this basically is a cylinder piercing through another cylinder on a very curved surface. So what I've done here, just to show you the procedure, is I've created 6 surface measurements approximately halfway down the thickness of the material. And so what we can do now is I'm just going to go to the construct ribbon. I'm going to go construct a circle, and we've added an enhancement to this to handle this kind of thing, and we call it a best fit projection. I'm going to select the 6 surface measurements. I have them all connected, all the surface measurements, kind of as one feature here. You can see the multi-point surface, that's 6 points. It doesn't matter, they could all be individual points and you can go and pick them individually or select them from the browser any way you want, so that doesn't really matter. They didn't have to be connected. I just did that for ease of use. So now I'm going to say enter, and you can see we get this constructed circle. It's a best fit projection through these points, and you can see it's kind of the center of it right now. It's piercing at the top, and if we look straight down, I'm just doing this by eye, but looking straight down, it's straight through that circle. So this is a new kind of best fit projection. This is a new kind of construction that we have, but it's automatically built in to the construct circle feature. Now, one of the other things we can do is I can actually hold my shift key down and I can move it. So if I actually wanted to report this maybe at a different depth, I can move it up or down because it's going up or down the axis. So I could just drop it off here and maybe I wanted to report it down here. Okay, so that's fine and dandy, but again, we used these surface measurements and we need to use something now a little more complex, because this is a thin-walled material. And not only is this a thin-walled material, but we can't even use regular trim checks on this because the side edge of this thin-walled material is not perpendicular to the surface. It actually goes back on a bit of an angle. So what I've got here, I'm just going to go in and open this next segment here. I've got some individual edge measurements, which is what we are using now instead of the trim check because of the inside edge. Now I'm just going to change this view to, I'm just going to look kind of straight down to make it easy for me to pick these features. But with the edge point, there's a kind of a vector on top on the surface, and then there's a vector on the inside. And that's the vector we want to pick on. So picking is a little bit more tricky for something like this, but I'm just going to zoom up and we're going to do the same thing. We're going to say construct a circle, and I'm going to just go around, and you can't do this from the browser because you want to make sure that you pick on the inside vector. If you pick on the top vector, then you'll get something completely different. Okay, now we'll just zoom out, and I wasn't looking straight down on that hole, but there you go, it's pretty darn close, and you can see the best fit projection. Now let's just double check on this. If I double click on that, and we go to the nominals tab here, we'll look at this circle is in the ZX plane, so the ZX coordinates are what are important. Z is 0, and X is 100, and the IJK is important also. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a screenshot of this, and I'm just going to move this over to the side a little bit, and we'll say OK, and then we're going to compare this back to the first one that we did, and let's double click on that. Okay, and then we'll bring up the two of them. Now if you recall, the one from the other segment we dragged down halfway, but you'll notice that the Z and X coordinates are identical. So whether you're doing this with surface measurements, maybe on a part that has a thicker material thickness, you could use surface measurements, or if you're using this on a very thin-walled material where it's even if it's on an angle and you have to use edge point measurements, not a problem. We got both covered. Thanks for watching today's Tech Tip.